Whenever I watch any movie from the Dark Knight trilogy, something hits me. In fact, that is what has made me watch it multiple times. Everybody can notice Heath Ledger's impeccable portrayal of Joker, the humongous production design, and the stunning visual effects in a tech-savvy Batman movie. But something hides in plain sight. It's there, right in front of us. Take the robbery scene at the beginning of The Dark Knight. Did you see that? That sudden change in intensity between the two shots? That abrupt transition? Editor Lee Smith has particular challenges in working with an auteur like Nolan, who had already been a part of editing in his first movie, Following, which also comprised of non-linear storytelling. One of the benefits of a complex story is that the continuity errors of a low-budget movie can be hidden without the audience even noticing it, making the editing easier. But at the same time, there comes another challenge of keeping it understandable. For the clarity to prevail, he uses what's known as smash cuts in his movies. A smash cut is an abrupt transition between two oxymoronic shots where the tone of the movie shifts drastically. Knowing Christopher Nolan's love for cross-cutting between multiple scenes running simultaneously, smash cutting helps in making the audience remember those scenes and finally connect the dots, hence keeping them engaged with the scene or the montage. But there is something special about how Lee Smith uses them. He cuts the shot when something is ongoing and that action is at the peak of its occurrence, like someone resisting an attack, or a gunshot, like everybody else, pal. Or a physical struggle. Another thing about Nolan movies that differentiates them from others is the way they edit the action sequences. If you look at the fight scene in any one movie of the Dark Knight series, let's say the duel between Batman and Bane, most of the shots are over-the-shoulder shots of both the characters, cutting between long shots, medium close-ups, and close-ups, along with few inserts and tracks. But in a Marvel movie, for example the final fight scene between Iron Man and Captain America, there are multiple quick cuts and insert shots from numerous angles. If mathematically compared, Batman fights Bane for around 2 minutes and 47 seconds, with a total of 61 cuts, giving an average of 0.36 cuts per second. Whereas the fight scene from Civil War lasts for around 5 minutes and 17 seconds, comprising of around 247 cuts, yielding an average of 0.78 cuts per second, which is more than double of what The Dark Knight Rises has. Compared to the Civil War sequence, Lee Smith places longer shots before cutting. That gives relatively more accurate information about the dynamics of the characters and their environment. Even though Civil War intends to give us a feeling of getting strangled through the rushful editing, Lee Smith gives us a sense of struggle through simple editing, which makes it more personal. But the difference between the both is that an excess of quick cuts and inserts has a higher probability of bringing confusion in both the physics of the body movement and the geometrical location of the characters. In order to solve that, the editors of Captain America Civil War brought intentional continuity errors, because the shots are so quick and the action so vigorous that it takes a little extra amount of time for the audience to process that information. But Lee Smith didn't have to break continuity. It was already so understandable. And both the editors used different techniques to keep the audience indulged. One uses realism, while the other makes the audience believe in unnatural motion of objects and characters. There is apparently no conscientical right or wrong when it comes to art, because a movie, however short, depends on nothing but how it is cut. Two or more shots, when put together, have to make sense. You shoot a movie one way, it might turn into something else in the editing room. Every cut defines something and has a potential to decide how the audience will perceive it. And in the end, a cut isn't really based on the software you use or the character on screen, but more on the instinct of the one who cuts it.